Here I want to find the last digit of 7 to the power of 2025, and we know how difficult it is if I want to directly calculate this big number. Generally, when we encounter such a question, there should be a trick. And the trick here is to find the pattern when we calculate 7 to the power of different numbers. What does that mean? I start by calculating 7 to the power of 1. This gives us 7, alright? And then calculate 7 to the power of 2. This gives us 49. 7 to the power of 3. This gives us 343. 7 to the power of 4, which we probably need the calculator, is 2,401. 7 to the power of 5 equals 6,807. Alright? And now you see that there is a pattern here. It's 7 first, I mean the last digit is 7, the last digit is 9, then 3, then 1, and again 7. And if I continue by calculating 7 to the power of 6, this gives me something where the last digit is 9. Okay, you can try that. But if we summarize this, then we'll see that the last digit repeats. It's 7 first, then it is 9, then it is 3, and then it is 1. And again, if I continue, this will be repeated. 7, 9, 3, 1. So here I can say if I calculate 7 to the power of 8, for example, then the last digit of that number would be 1. Now I want to find what is the last digit of 7 to the power of 2025. And for that, I need to calculate the remainder of dividing 2025 by 4, because this length of this pattern is 4. Alright? And if I do that, then we'll get here 5 times 4, and then we'll get 24 here, then the remainder is 1. Alright? The remainder is 1. That means the last digit of this number, 7 to the power of 2025, is actually the first number in the pattern, or it is 7 to the power of 1. So this means the last digit here is 7, because 7 is the first number in the pattern.